Okay, first of all, it's all ass backwards to go to a club to meet someone in the first place. I don't and never have gone to a club to meet someone with the intent of developing an intimate relationship. Never. And I don't and never have been receptive to juvenile mentalities. Never. Even when I was young, which pretty much rules out the possibility of catching someone like me at a hip-hop joint to begin with. And as you mentioned, it doesn't help that you got to watch your back for fights and shooting and other avoidable drama with ghetto mentalities. And yes, I am saying that the hip-hop mentality is generally synonymous with ghetto mentalities. Like it or not, it is. So given that, I love dancing and music, specifically classic R&B and jazz. Now, you mentioned that people will go to a place because they want to meet the type of people in that place. For the record, I'll again reiterate that I never went out to meet people. I went out because I enjoy music and dancing. And for a dude to assume that I'm out to meet some guy in a club is a turnoff in itself for me. So with all that in mind, the music I enjoy most fits the mentality of the people I'd feel most comfortable around, upscale and mature people. So yeah, I'd be found at an upscale venue with mature patrons. Now, most often jazz lounges would be the most diverse, but I counter the idea that my blackness should condone receptiveness to a dude just because we may be two of the few black people in the lounge. Just because we're both black doesn't mean he approached me like a gentleman, which is what determines whether I respond at all. And if a guy takes that response as being mean, then he likely was not a gentleman I would mesh with in the first place, because I don't do weak in any gender nor hue. And rarely, yes, he could turn his head and find some old white dude talking to me, offering me a drink, but you can best believe his drink got turned down as well. It's just that a real difference between white men buying drinks and black men buying drinks is that black men ask first to see if it's in their budget to be worth it to buy you a drink if they can get some play. When these old white men tend to buy one without motive simply because they want you to have one. That's not to say they don't hope their generosity will be noticed and reciprocated, but if it does go unnoticed, they don't sensitively take it personal. They just wanted to buy a lady a drink. And even telling a white dude that you don't like white men won't deter him, and he'll maintain that he's just there without motive. But a weak brother usually doesn't last a few sentences with me before he reveals himself. Now, there have been a rare few black men who watched me long enough to already know I'd turn it down, and they'd send one anyway. Those are the men who wanted to buy me a drink without motive and without caring one way or other whether I responded to them personally. So a gentleman buys a drink just because he wants to do it. So on the drink buying tips, I always turn them down. And usually the bartender knows I turn them down, so she'll let them know before she even bothers to ask me or he, whichever the bartender is. And the reaction of gentlemen will stand out when you do refuse a drink. And for the record, chicks like the one you responded to are one of the many reasons why my female friend scale is low. Like I said, I don't do weak. And the sad news is that most are like her. And I've even had females ask me why I turn down drinks, you know, and they refer to it as mean as well. And those are the same females that are the ones complaining in my ear about how they can't get rid of some dude they let buy them a drink. So, and I've had a black man ask me to buy him a drink. And that's happened on a couple of occasions. And I did it. I'll do it. I mean, because like in the female's case, it's totally not worth a $5 or $10 drink to have somebody that you cannot get rid of that you didn't come to the club to see. And on the other hand, but the same results, sure, I'll buy this ridiculous dude a drink who asked me to buy him a drink thinking that it was cute. I'll buy, sure, what are you drinking? And as soon as the bartender brings a drink to him, that's the last of our conversation. I don't have anything. He's already showing me what kind of person he is by asking a female he doesn't know to buy him a drink. Now, on a good note, if I see a fellow carrying himself like a gentleman, if I see a brother and he seems to be a gentleman at a bar, it rarely happens, but it happens, I'll send him a drink. I'll do it anonymously because I don't want it to motivate or invite a conversation, but I'll do it just because I appreciate him being a man, because you don't see it often. So, you know, it's not going to cost me much out of my pocket when I rarely see them. The bottom line is that I don't go out to meet anyone. The places I prefer are upscale, mature, and half the time diverse based on the prospect of being surrounded by upscale, mature people who still know how to let their hair down without being ignorant. I prefer the company of mature brothers, but it's unlikely that you'll find any one spot just spilling over with that caliber of man. So, yeah, I turn them down left and right, but that rare percentage who approach me like gentlemen are rarely overlooked. This is why I have never, ever hosted an unhealthy relationship and never shared my intimate company with anything less than a man. Not some dude walking around with a penis, but a man. And this is even when I was a young woman. I mean, dudes have manhood all screwed up, and sadly, women do too, which is why they constantly engage little boys who should be men by their age. And because I don't go out to meet guys in the first place, I could care less what they're looking for, but I do find brothers who dig white women unattractive in general. It doesn't anger or offend me that they love white women, and I encourage them to follow their hearts. They'll just never get any personal attention from me. So at the risk of sounding like white people, some of my best friends like white women, but those particular friends are not even really enjoyable to flirt with. Kind of, you know, kind of grosses me out, in fact. But one has to have so much character to befriend me in the first place. I got crazy love for my friends. So, anywho, I'm just saying that you are so off base when you say that women go to a place to meet people in that place. So off base. But then again, I'm particularly as unique as the gentlemen who do capture my attention. And for the record, old girl that was looking for people to buy, for dudes to buy her a drink, that really is pathetic. A-Gray told you right, it's pathetic. And the gentlemen you claim to be looking for are not attracted to women who go out and do that. And yes, you can be spotted a mile away by those type of men. Really pathetic. I co-sign that.